Lady Shushu, the next world is in sight.
Wow, that was fast. So I was right to bring the worlds closer together.
Outside! Hurry outside!
Actually, I was thinking that might not be the best idea right now. Everyone out there might be in a panic.
Oh, I'm sure it's fine. I don't think people are too worried about little details like that.
If you honestly think everyone's as dopey as you, you're in for a big surprise.
That was kinda mean.
Now, we can't undo what's already been done.
Maybe, but as a hero, I'm not sure about being on the same side as a bunch of troublemakers.
Oh, well, you know, Ryuto and I are both heroes too, so...
That doesn't make me feel better in the slightest.
But... yeah, I guess so.
Come on! Don't sit there with those sour looks on your faces! We need to make the best of things!
Now that I really think about it, I've been just following them around. But there's no proof that she's not an evil god. If she's got some evil reason for wanting to become an ultimate god again, then...
Huh? What's wrong? Is there something on my face? Oh, but I just washed it.
Nope. No way. It was dumb of me to even consider it.
Huh? What's dumb?
Nothing. I was just thinking how dumb your face looked.
What? So mean!
Come on, stop flirting and get ready to go! I'm gonna conquer this world before breakfast!
Good evening, everyone, and welcome back. Okay, so we're at the start of Chapter 5 now. And what I've done off camera is did a little bit more level grinding, goes up to level 29. And what we're going to do today is probably go ahead and check out the next world, which is Silver World. But just before that, what we're going to do is very quickly go ahead and sort of speak to everybody, see if they have any items for us. Not sure why there's a cat here. Okay, well, you don't have anything for me, so you're no good to me. Oh, you're gonna give me something. Swift Pill, Spirit Pill, and Power Pill, I think that was. Right, I still only have one bronze ticket, so you're kinda no good to me either. Now, you've got a pirate hat on, so you must have something good, surely. Nope, oh well. Right, what about the snake? Scales. I made you this. You can have it if you want. Oh, right. Give me something good, come on. Ankle socks and thin apron. So the good news is we do have a pair of ankle socks there, which I kind of want to equip to somebody. Let's see. We'll just have a quick little look, see who's actually got what and out. Didn't I already have you, Bianca? Oh, we gave you, but they gave the other ones away, didn't we? Right, so it seems like we've got another rubber suit there that I didn't realise I had. So I'm going to give that to now. That means then what I can do is go ahead and give the ankle socks to Ryoto, I think. Just kind of seems like the better plan. Other than that, as I say, now I did manage to go ahead and give Serma an iron sickle that became available in the shop while I was sort of just level grinding. So clearly as I'm level grinding, the further I go in levels, the more weapons that are becoming available, and I managed to actually give her an iron sickle that was available. I don't think there was any other weapons that I was gifted at the time. I think there's still a few ingredients or items that we need to kind of sell on in order for some more to become available to us. May as well speak to you as well. You want to give me something to it? I got a Roman sword there and miso soup. I don't know what the top one was there. We did get a weapon, but again, it's just a sword, which isn't really kind of useful to me. Let's go ahead and sort of speak to all yous, see if you've got anything for me. Now, we haven't been to the Mugen Field yet, but we are going to go before we go to the next world, because that's my plan. Because in the first game when we did the Mugen Field, I think it was up to the first one was level 10, and it unlocked a few benefits for us. I can't remember what it unlocked, but I want to kind of see if the same thing happens again. Right, what about you? I think you're Sustika. I haven't seen her at all. Well, give me the mask then. Oh, you guys down here don't like giving me in, do you, surely? Oh, okay. Only 7, that's like 4 hours more than I got. I couldn't sleep at all. I'd love to sleep 13 hours again. Right, well, nobody wanted to give me any items, it seemed like, which is kind of a shame. Well, down here anyway, we got a few up the top there. But as I said, I do want to check out the Mugen Field, just because I want to see if it unlocks any items for us, or benefits or something like that. Okay, so it says we've got to kind of continue from the beginning. Well, obviously, because we haven't done anything in it yet. Arrange. I think we should be alright with the party we've got, because Ryu and Sasuke are only level 19, so they're obviously leveling up slower because they're in the sub party, which is fine. I haven't really sort of decided to use them at the moment. Okay, so can we begin? No, you must bet over 100 points. Okay. Well, I guess I've got to bet 100 points then. What do I actually have? Well, I've got 22,166 there, so I'm guessing all the level grind has paid off. What's the maximum I can do? 1,000. Now, will that be too much for us? Because I don't know how much we should really bet. Tell you what, we'll go with 100, because that's what it kind of says we have to kind of start with. And then if I have to change it up at some point, we can, I guess. So we'll begin with that. Another tutorial. Right, before you actually head out the Mugen Field, you have to select your desired route. Okay, now I remember when we did it the last time, if we wanted all the story, we had to kind of pick the more higher one. Obviously, we haven't got our charm levels up very high yet, so. The normal route has no distinctive features to speak of, whilst the carnage route means even stronger enemies will show up. Okay. There's also a whimsy route where a variety of special events are more likely to appear. Yeah, so that's the side we want if we want any story stuff, I guess. Just like it was in the last game. Certain routes require a minimum number of charm points from Serma or must be unlocked from the Mugen shop. Okay. That's all it's kind of given us anyway. Can I do the... what's going on? Are you only letting me do regular right now? Okay, well, if it's only gonna let me do regular, then fair enough. Unless I can change something. No, that's not right. Okay. Well, it seems like it's only gonna let me do regular right now, so we'll just pick that. I'm not sure if it kinda changes if I would have bet more MP for it, but alright. Guess I'm speaking then. So, we ended up here anyway. We've come this far already, so stop complaining. Yeah, I'm a little curious myself now. So what is this place anyway? It's way bigger than it should be for being inside a ship. It's creepy. Well, that's I shouldn't explain whilst Lady Shushu is here. Huh? How come? Is there something you can't tell me? Or, what? Ah, thank you all for coming. I couldn't force us to all come here with my current size, so I was unsure of what to do. Whoa, she turned into her graceful form. Why the heck did you just change all of a sudden? I apologise, it was somewhat urgent matter, so I thought I would come. I thought it would be best to tell you right away. Yeah, I'm gonna have to watch what I'm reading here. I'm slightly a bit tired today. Just like that, I thought Lady Shushu is the one who creates this place in her changed form, so did something happen? Yes, I would like to ask you to keep it a secret from Shushu. We did that in the last game as well, didn't we? Secret? But aren't you the Munchkin? Shushers wants us to keep it a secret from Shushers. You'll understand in a minute, probably. Indeed, it seems I will need to explain from here. Lady Shushu's alternate personalities made this Mugen Field while keeping it a secret from Lady Shushu. What? But she's still Shushu's when she changes, right? Are you saying the Munchkin's a different person right now? Technically, no. I am the same person, but I suppose thinking of me as a different person may make it easier to understand. Huh? So what you're saying is you took over Shushu's body? I suppose that's one way to put it. However, I didn't do it with any kind of bad intentions. Our different personalities originally created this place because they wanted to talk to us more. Huh? That's kind of cute. They all seem like they're having their own faulty personalities though. Anyway, allow me to get to the main point. You could say this Mugen Field is within Shushu's mind, but there has been a bit of trouble. Is that because she's been shrunk down? I was hoping that you could all lend us your aid. Trouble in her mind, huh? Do you mean like a Shushu sick or something? Well, I'm pretty sure it has to do with you, Serma. I'm pronouncing that right, Serma. Huh? Me? Yes, I believe it's because her body has shrunk. I thought that, and some of her abilities have been absorbed. Oh, I see. But that's Shushu's own fault for going into the coffin on her own. And you and you alone have to take responsibility for this. Not that I want to get involved in this mess. What? Don't be some mean nosy. Oh no, I didn't mean to make you take responsibility or anything. It's just that if we leave her like this, I don't know what will happen later on. Therefore, this is a request from all of us. Please help. Please. If you help us, you can do whatever you like to me. Oh yeah, you kind of like that, don't you? Just shut up and do as you're told. That'll be fun. I'm only asking you guys because there's no one else that can help. If you don't do it, you'll regret it. I don't really get it, but I think it'd help us a lot. Now, all of Lady Shushu's are bowing their heads and begging for our help. Actually, most of them didn't. Nosy. Ugh, fine. I'll do it. Okay. Thank you. So what exactly do you need us to do? Nothing too difficult. We just need you to reach the very end of this place. When you reach the right place, Shushu should recognise it. That's all. You just want us to walk to the end, right? I guess I can do that. However, the traps that we left for Shushu can be a bit malice. Well, why did you leave traps? We need you to take care of those as well. I'm starting to get a bad feeling about all of this. What kind of traps? Some powerful monsters could appear, or a warship could suddenly come out and attack. Well, hold on. Why didn't you say that in the first place? Well, I'll leave it up to you. We'll see you later again. Wait, if it's that dangerous, then... what? Why are you yelling at me? Because you just... Nah, you need to watch, because she's just changed back to her normal form now. Oh, Lady Shushu doesn't know about this place, so please keep it a secret. Ugh, a secret, huh? Me, huh? My head feels all hazy. Don't worry about it. Let's get going, okay? Alright, we came here to have some fun, huh? Alright, let's go. I'm getting dragged into trouble again, aren't I? Now, if you just give it a chance, I'm sure you'll have fun. Oh, okay, so we are going into battles then.
Shall we go all out?
Now, is it just going to be the sort of enemies that we had the last time we were in the Mugen Field in the first game? Sunflower? Yeah, okay, so it should just be a matter of just attacking. I think because I haven't picked the other route, it's probably not going to show us any sort of cutscenes or anything like that. So it probably will just be 10 rounds of the enemies, I'd say. Did I not kill that thing?
I'll take you.
Thought
one.
I did.
Here I come.
There we go, that's better. That's right, so as I say, if it is just going to be 10 rounds of battles, what I'm going to do is I'll probably cut out all the other battles, because it's going to get boring if I'm just showing 10 exact the same battles. If something interesting happens right enough, then I'll obviously keep them in, and then eventually once we get to 4, I think, I'm hoping it's going to be 4, 10, because the last time I think it was 10, then 30, I can't remember if it was 60, and I don't think I went past any part of that for the story the last time, so I'm hoping it goes to 10. Okay, so we do have a 4, this is the level 10. Right, so let's see what we have here. We have a passionate warrior, and he has 2,408 HP and 2,408 HP and 270 SP. Okay, and we just kind of have the regular other enemies here, so I can kind of just take care of these guys first, so they're out of the way, so we don't have to worry too much about them. So all the previous rounds beforehand were just basically the same enemies, there was nothing interesting or anything like that happened. Oh, I was hoping I'd kind of steal something there. That's alright, you didn't really do very much damage to me there.
Let's
get rid of this other doll.
Here I come.
There we go. Right, so I should now just be able to kind of just lay into this person. Doesn't seem like he's doing any damage to me, so that's fine. Kind of want to steal though, just in case they have something. Ah, paralysis. Okay, so it wasn't anything great. Would have been nice if it had been a weapon or something like that.
My turn.
Now I do have these special skills, I've not really actually done anything with them, so maybe I could just use one of them then out, see if it does
I'll
anything decent.
My true strength now.
Okay, that's pretty good. Probably could have just one-shotted them, to be honest with you, but I'm quite happy with that.
I swear on Lady Shusha's name.
Now I got that special skill by just leveling up, and eventually it just kind of unlocked itself. So let's see, we didn't really get anything decent from that, to be honest with you. So, Silver Ore, I don't think I needed one of them. I think it was a iron lump I needed for some of one weapon that I'm kind of looking for. All right, we got 5 gold, 108 experience, and 4 points. Again, it's probably because I only bet 100 points. I'm not too fussed with. This is different. Because in the last time it used to just come up a screen. Can I jump? Yes, I can. Now, what have I do? Can I speak to you? Let me see if to you. Just want to see if you do anything. Mugen Field rest stop. Once you clear a certain floor in the Mugen Field, you arrive at a rest stop. Here you'll find treasure chests and also have the ability to spend your Mugen points to beef up your party members. There will also be a powerful boss waiting at the end, which will give you the opportunity for even more experience and rare items. You'll also have the option of continuing on without fighting the boss. So decide on the best course of action depending on the situation. Leave the rest stop, select either next or exit. Okay. Next will allow you to continue fighting in the Mugen Field. Exit will allow you to leave the Mugen Field completely. If you do exit to return to your home base, you can select to continue any time to head back and move to the next floor. Okay. So use the Mugen Dev Center to strengthen your characters. Engage or ignore the enemy. That's all good. Alright, okay. So let's just end that then. Right, Mugen Dev Center. So this is pretty much, I think, what it was like the last time. At the Mugen Rest Stop, you'll find the Mugen Dev Center, the Mugen Exchange, and the Mugen Control Room. First up, let's talk about the Mugen Dev Center. Here you can use your Mugen points to develop your character's abilities. You can also increase the maximum value of damage carnivals or enhance and unlock different effects to be applied to your party. Finally, you can increase the skills, add jobs, or unlock characters' hidden powers. Now let's move on to the Mugen Exchange. Here you can spend Mugen points to unlock new voices or CGs. I'm not too worried about all that sort of stuff. Or we can change appearance. Okay, I'm not too worried about all that. Let me tell you about the Mugen Control Room. Here you can change your battle commands to be used in the Mugen Field. I didn't really bother too much about all that the last time either. For example, you select Magic Skill Sealed, then you will no longer be able to use magic skills. Yeah, I'm not going to bother with any of that. I don't really see the point in kind of sealing abilities for myself. It's just going to make it harder. I understand it's saying there that you'll probably be rewarded with more like gold and all, or G or whatever. But to be honest with you, I don't want to limit myself. I'd rather just kind of be able to use whatever skills I wanted. Alright, the only one I kind of really want to see is, okay, so we can do it from here. Right, I just want to look at the Dev Center. What do I have? I've got 22,000 points. Can I add some defense slots? Yes, I can. So I want to actually add these. They're only 500. Oh god, that's 50,000 for another one. Okay, that's going to take a while to do that. Can I do this for everybody though? I should have enough points though. Right, so the good news is it means that now I can equip another piece of gear or onto our armor slots at least. So that's good. Is there anything else I can do? I need to add sub parties because I remember, right, we had to add to keep boosting this so that everybody would be in our sub party or they don't come up on the list, I think. So I'm going to do that. So next one is 10,000. Now, the reason it's blanked out is it means I've got to actually go through the next stages of the Mugen Field in order to unlock if I want to kind of increase it even more, which I'm not going to do right now. Upgrade carnival damage. I mean, I don't really understand too much about the carnival damage sort of thing, the damage carnival thing. I mean, it's only 1,000, so I guess I could do it. I'll look into it probably a bit more. I know when I've been kind of doing a lot of damage it's been giving me, it's flashing up on the screen and it gives me a bit of like gold or something, but alright. Unlock. Right, so this is just jobs if I want to create things, I guess, which I'm not going to bother with. Level cap. Okay, so we can do up to a level. We're capped at a level 100. Let's see, that's 10. Yeah, I'm not going to touch that because that's going to burn through a lot of my points right now. Learn a skill. Right, so it's not going to let me... No, it's not going to let me upgrade anything just now. Can I add? Right, so I can add additional ones, which I think is more the best thing to kind of do. So I'm going to try and add some of these. This is probably going to burn through quite a lot of my points. The reason I'm adding it, Ryu and Sasika as well just now is because I don't know if there's going to be anything in the future that's going to require me to use them. What about learn condition? Nope, can't do any of that. strength and skill. I don't want to strengthen any of my skills right now, because if I strengthen them, it's going to take up more SP, and I don't want to do any of that right now until I'm ready to the point of where I'm kind of boosting gear or anything like that up. So that's fine. Latent ability, I don't know what all that is. I didn't really read any of it the last time, I don't think. So I'm not going to bother with that right now. I think that's all I can kind of really want to do at the moment. I'm going to keep those 11,000 points. Right. Now, what I'm thinking is, if I jump into this thing here, is that going to make it a monster? No, tell me there's a monster there. Right, so I guess I've got to fight that monster to continue past. If I do that, that's going to maybe continue on a bit of the story. Which means I'm going to leave just now, because I'm not really planning on doing most of the Mugen Field at the moment. I just kind of wanted to see if it would unlock stuff to help us out. So I'm going to leave just now. Didn't really get much for it, but okay, not too worried about that. Right, and now we're out. We do have this other challenge world. I'm not going to bother with that right now, because I kind of want to try and get into the story a bit more today. I do, however, want to go and see if I can buy any additional gear now, or at least armour. Well, I've got 4 of these already, apparently. I can't make any Anglo Socks. I still don't have the Hoodlum Mask. I don't know where they are. I still don't have any Tortoise Shells. And I don't have any Sentient Circuits to make them. So I already have 4 of them apparently on me. So I guess that's the 4 things I'm going to have to equip onto our team. Unless I have any different. I don't think so. Yep, so I guess putting on a simple t-shirt's the best option I can do right now. Let's see, it was Shiragani, it was my other one. And what I'll do is put a bra onto you guys. Just in case you end up coming into battle at some point and it's unexpected, if it just switches you to into my team for no reason. But alright, I think that's everything else we can kind of do just now. So what we're going to do is do a very quick save, so I don't have to do any of the Mugen Field stuff again. God, I'm at 15 hours of this already just because I've been level grinding a lot for items. What I should actually do is sell some of the items that I got from the Mugen Field. I got some yellow petals from a couple of the enemies, which I kind of was looking for. I couldn't remember what world had those the last time, so I'm going to sell all these. And what I should do is kind of look to see if I can buy any new weapons at the moment. So let's see, I need... Right, so I still can't do Tortoise Shell or anything like that for them, for real too. Right, so I've already got the Iron Sickle for her. So I still need an Iron Lump. Apparently I can do a Twisty. But I don't have an Iron Lump, I don't know where those come from. And I've already got a Steel Dagger on her, I think, at the moment as well. So yeah, I can't really do anything with weapons then, so that's fine. Right, so what we're going to do now is we're just going to go ahead and jump into Silver World. We do have a few more sort of planet spots or master points to kind of take care of in the Spice of Ruins, but we'll probably leave that for the next episode. I do want to just kind of continue on a bit now because we've done that Mugen Field. So let's just jump into Silver World then and see what's happening.
Here we... Ryu, I go first!
No, I'm first. I get to take the first step.
But Shushers, you're not even walking.
Hey, Tsukika, where's the rope?
I'm sorry. She took off before I could tie her up.
Listen, there is no way I'm gonna go running around to catch her again. Ryuto, go get her!
Yes, ma'am! But I'm pretty sure it's gonna be impossible to catch up to her.
Young lady, it is most impolite to go running around like that.
Ryu?
Ray, wait! There she is! Huh? There's someone with her.
You there! Don't let go of her!
As you wish.
Let me down! Down!
Phew. That was close. How many times have I told you not to run off on your own?
I'm sorry.
Come now. It's in a child's nature to be so energetic. And as you can see, she's quite apologetic.
That's a good point. Anyway, sorry about all the trouble. You really helped us out.
I'm glad I could be of service. Is this young lady your daughter, perhaps?
Daughter? No. She's more like a pet.
Shirogane, don't say things like that. You're gonna give people the wrong idea.
What should we do? I was gonna tie her up, but if we do that now...
Well, everyone has different tastes. As long as all involved parties are in agreement, I see no problem with it.
No, it's not like that!
Ryu? Gun is all red!
Okay, enough of all the silliness. We're just lucky we ran into someone from this world.
But what were you doing here, mister?
What an odd question. When you have guests, it's only proper that you greet them as a true gentleman.
What? You mean, you knew we were coming? How?
Well, let's just say, it was a gentleman's intuition.
Your decision to give me a proper greeting is most praiseworthy. So very well, you shall become my peon.
Oh, what do we have here? What an adorably pocket-sized young lady. But what do you mean by peon?
Listen close. I am Lady Shushu, the overwhelmingly beautiful, undisputed god of the universe who's come to conquer this world!
I see. Oh, but how rude of me! I haven't introduced myself yet. I am Bertram Demetrius Bloomfield. If it pleases you, you may call me Bertram.
Whoa, super long name!
I don't care about your name. I told you already, become my peon!
An interesting invitation, but I'm afraid I must decline. You see, I already have a master I've devoted myself to.
What? What are you talking about?
Bertram? So, how about Rammy? Or, no, Birdie might be better.
Bertie? My, what a cute nickname, but also a bit embarrassing.
Oh, you don't like it? Then I guess I don't have to call you that.
No, not at all. I wouldn't dream of declining your kindness. I am honored to accept it.
Hey! How can you turn down being my peon but accept some stupid nickname?
If I must answer, becoming one's peon and accepting a nickname are in entirely different categories.
Hey, can we get things moving here?
Now she's getting annoyed. Sorry.
Honestly. Now, Bertram was it? Listen, we're looking for whoever's in charge of this world. Do you know who that might be?
You're looking for who's in charge? Well, there can be none other than my master.
Your master?
Yes, indeed. My master is a most wonderful woman. Her mere smile gives energy to the people of this world. Her presence is the embodiment of all the hopes and dreams for...
Sorry, but we're not here to listen to you go on and on about your master.
This is kind of strange. Things seem to be going surprisingly smoothly for us.
The way I see it, we've been running into way too much trouble up till now.
Okay, so where's this master of yours?
Well, I'm afraid I must ask what you intend to do if and when you obtain such information.
I'm gonna make her my peon, duh!
Stupid?
What? Why am I stupid?
She's so stupid!
That's just like your opinion. What gives you the right to call me stupid?
Do you really not know?
If that is your intention, I'm afraid I cannot introduce you to my master. Please, return to wherever you came from.
I'm afraid I saw this coming. Shushers?
Huh? What? Did I do something wrong?
Hey, when she says make her my peon, we're not gonna do anything awful to her. Can't we at least just talk and...
If you refuse to leave peacefully, I must do my duty and eliminate any threat to my master. Prepare yourselves!
Ugh. This is all your fault, Pipsqueak!
What did I do? And don't call me Pipsqueak!
Come on,
Shooter. Well, looks like we're going into another battle. Ooh, he's got a big... Ooh, two big things next to him. Okay. Right, let's see what these big things are. A red javelin that has 813 HP and 420 SP. What's that in? That's alright, I just wanted to be sure it's not standing in something that can be used against us. But okay, so we've got Bertram. It has 4,444 HP, very precise, and 3,327 SP, so it's probably going to be quite magic-y based, fair enough, right. So I guess the only thing I can do is try and get rid of these big things first.
Watch me, Lady Shushu!
Oops, I didn't mean to hit him, I was trying to hit the big green machine things or whatever they are. I'm gonna see if I can steal from him. Not. We got a rocket launcher from him there. And I don't know how much damage he's doing, right? So they are hitting kind of hard.
Ready?
I'm gonna have to take them out very quickly here, so I may have to use some decent skills that I have.
I'll take you on.
Now, I do have some kind of special skills around here, so we got this mecha assassination. So I think it's time to start using these kind of skills if possible.
You're a waste of my time. Take this! My all-out attack!
Ouch! Watch me, Lady Shushu!
It didn't really do as much as I thought it was going to do, but okay. I thought it was going to do a lot more. Alright, it's only got four left.
This.
At least it's done anyway. Right, and I kind of see what health he's got. Right, he's still got quite a bit, so that's fine. So do you. You're alright and you're alright. Okay. Just wanted to be sure, because you never know how much HP things are going to take off you. I do want to steal from this red javelin. Do you have melon shampoo? Okay. That might be quite handy to remember. You can kind of steal shampoos from them. Not sure why a mech would have shampoo, but I'm not here to question it. I'll just use rock. I just wanted to kind of just a bit too far away. Oh, right, where are you standing in now? Evasion up. Okay, so we need to kind of... Sadly, it means I'm going to have to put Blast off on and get him out of that, or we're never going to be able to attack him. Right, so I kind of need him to come out of there, and... If he's going to go there, that should be fine. Well, that's going to move over and he's going to be over there, so I kind of want him... over this way if possible. I'm just trying to see where he's going to hit, to be honest with you. Yeah, that's probably a bit better for him to be.
Here I go.
Okay, it kind of went a bit further than I thought it was going to do. Ooh, that was a big hit there. Yeah, I kind of need to actually start getting rid of these things. Oh, I can probably take off the blast off now. There we go. Right, so now it's only him left, so let's get ourselves down here. Do I actually have a heal? I do have a petite heal. Kind of want to try and get it to go to it. Just kind of heal him up a little bit more. Just because he kind of took a bit of thing there. Right, so magic damage is up, which means I kind of want to kind of stay away from that as far as possible. Alright, so he heals from his attack, so I'm going to have to watch out for that.
I am fully prepared.
Wonder if he's going to try and run back into that evasion or not. Oh, we do have Rainbow Tower. I guess we could kind of see what this does. Now, so it seems like it's with Serma again. Oh, there's three of them. Oh, it's happening. Okay. Right, so I feel like I'm going to have to try and boost up those attacks because they're not really doing anything major to them. Okay, so I've got a Cosmic Loveliness here. So I wonder if that will kind of take care of them. So it's got 3,217 left. Is this going to be enough? Because Rotos did quite a lot of damage the last time.
I cannot allow this. I cannot allow this.
All done. Okay, I think we've got him.
Cannot allow.
There we go. That was actually not too bad. That kind of went not too bad. And we didn't get anybody sort of KO on our end like that. Right. So we got 575 gold, 1488 experience and 292 points. We got a rocket launcher, melon shampoo, a brocken, plastic vest, chestnut head and dust bunny shampooers. And Semra's now went up to level 30. Same with Ryuta, Jogani, Ryu. Now going to be level 30, please? No? Oh well. Maybe next time. And okay, it seems like it's me again, so... Right, quite the formidable opponents. I did not expect to be defeated like this. Yeah, you're no stranger to combat yourself, it would seem. You're so strong, Bertram. Now then, we beat you fair and square, so now tell me where your master is. I'm afraid I cannot. Why not? Ugh. Why don't people from this world listen to me even when they're loose? Yep, we really do look like the bad guys here. I'm supposed to be a hero. You can't think about that. No good can come from it. Normally I would battle you until my very spirit gave out. But I must attend to the most urgent matter. I bid you farewell. Excuse me. Is he off? And he's ran away. You're not getting away that easily. Ryo, get him. Okay, Ryo's gonna get. Ugh, don't just take off like that. You've still got the rope around you. Oh, okay. Oh, she's choked it. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry, Ryo. I think we could probably just kind of do away with the rope at some point, surely. There. You don't have to cry. Everything's gonna be fine, okay? Nick Hurts surprised me. Wah, okay. Well, this is a pretty weird situation. Yeah, and Betty's nowhere to be in sight now. I was about to just kind of say nowhere to be seen there. Come on. Now we have to walk around and look for him all over again. I guess it's back to the usual grind. Okay. Looks like we've finally arrived. Let's go back to the G Castle just now, just so it kind of heals us up a bit here. There we go. Right. And we'll just kind of do another save just because we did that battle and it's just easier to kind of do again if my switch kind of just turns itself off or has an error again. Right, let's go back in here. Right, so let's have a look now that we're here. So we've got Silver World, so it says we're heading over here, so that's fine. At least I've got a kind of direction. Seems like there's a warp there. That's fine. Let's have a look at the planet points or master points or whatever they're called. It likes quiet girls. Okay, so that's going to be Terse. What levels do I actually have everybody at? 6%? Okay. Wonder if that's going to be enough for this area. If not, I might have to kind of go and try and do those other ones. Now, we probably will have a few new enemies in here, so we may as well get that out of the way. Oh, tell why. There's actually a treasure chest there I want, first of all. Rubber swimsuit, sugar candy, and power pill. Okay, can I get this number one? I just want to see if we can actually do this. So let's do Terse. See if we're actually strong enough for this area. Right, so Terse is going to be maybe Love Beam. Fry, it's not really the greatest ones to pick right enough, and appear. Might take Love a few beam. Turns to kind of get Cheers. It. Yeah, they're totally wrong, these ones.
Bring it on.
Right, do we have any new enemies in this? Oh, we do have a couple of new enemies, so we may as well just kind of show this battle off. Right, we've got our Dactyls. It has 380 HP, 189 SP. We have a Hickey. Or Hikey, 297 HP, 294 SP, and we have a Netherworld Penguin which has 232 HP, 357 SP. Okay, right, may as well just get rid of these then.
Here I come!
Watch me, Lady Shushu!
This kind of lets me know if my gear's alright or not. Okay, well, we kind of missed there, so that's
what
good.
What should I do?
I kind of want to see if I can steal from you. Insane mask. Okay, I was kind of wondering because we are kind of looking for a hoodlum mask, I think, for one of the items. I was kind of wondering if that the mask on that thing would have kind of worked. I guess it's a different mask it drops. Don't you hit us. That's not nice. Now we are taking a little bit of damage, which is kind of alright. It's not the worst thing, but.
Take this.
Definitely that extra armor piece is going to come in handy that we just got from doing the Mugen field at least.
Right,
let's see
do?
If we can get anything to drop from you. Flexible Ivy. Okay, well, we're doing quite well with doing the stealing anyway. There we go. Right. 159 gold, 390 experience, and 132 points. Got a hollow bone, insane mask, flexible Ivy, worn out, drill sealed, and newbie shampoos. And Maskus is level 7. What am I supposed to be looking for? Terse, come on. Give me Terse. Give me Terse.
Level 7.
Right, I'm gonna try it again, and if not, then we'll just continue on. I don't want to spend too much time doing all this, so maybe wanna die, heart skips a beat, and little devil.
My heart is pounding.
Ooh, okay, so that's pretty close. So I may have to kind of do this a few more times just to kind of see if I can get this up. So I may have to do a wee bit of a transition again. Alright, we got it this time then. That's not too bad. Didn't really take any other additional battles there from that last one. Right, so let's see, we've got number one, so number two is Craven Meat. Okay, so where's that on the map? So number two is over there, okay, but there is a warp there. Okay, so I guess I've got to go there because it doesn't seem like I can go anywhere else, so that's fine. So let's see, we've already fought one of them. We've got a bat there, that's kind of new. I guess I should kind of go this way, there might be another bat elsewhere. Alright, so that's the way we came, so that's fine. So let's go through this warp, see what it's taking us. Right, so we do have additional bats there, so let's do the cutscene first. Oh, hey Shushers, one of your friends is on this world too, right? Oh yeah, I totally forgot. I mean, she's a peon, not a friend. Peon, okay? Who is it that's here though? I don't see why she's still so hung up on that. Speaking of which, Kiro, who did you drop off here? Please be Altus, because I need somebody with a gun. It's been a while, so my memory's a bit hazy. I think it was Alice. Ugh, I don't want Alice, I want Altus. Lassie? Ah, that little missy. If it's Alice we're talking about, I bet she hasn't made any progress whatsoever conquering this world. Nope. That doesn't sound like Alice, I remember. I'd like to think you're wrong, but it is Alice. Is this Alice girl really that useless? I wouldn't say useless, she's just unbelievably weak. But she is the Demon Lord of Fireworld. She wasn't very strong though. Isn't being strong kind of essential for a Demon Lord? Well, that little missy may be physically weak, but she was something of a pop idol. She was extremely popular with the men of Fireworld, so she was going fine. She was doing fine as a Demon Lord. A Demon Lord and an idol? My image of a demon lord is melting before my eyes. So she's a super weak demon lord, huh? Oh, the Fireworld's hero is even weaker than her. Much weaker. Jessica, that's not helping. Alice's case, all that much. Elka isn't just weak, he's more like completely useless. Kaka? So, there's a hero out there that's even worse than a super duper demon lord. I wouldn't say he's completely useless, but he is kind of incompetent, though. Hey, well, he does drive the G-Castle when you're not doing it. He's good at piloting, yeah, precisely. I remember that's what he was doing from the last game. But his other abilities and personality are kind of... I'm sorry, I can't even think of any good points about him. Well, he's a bit of a romantic, isn't he? Now my mental image of a hero. Aww, now he's taking this pretty hard. I think she's even more depressed once she actually meets him. Well, he's an interesting guy to say the least. Cheer up, Nowsy. Oh well. I bet you're not going to give me Altus to the very end, aren't you? Because you know that's the one we want. What's this? Okay, I thought that was maybe something there. Right. So I'm looking for... Oh, there's a treasure chest over there. And that's exactly where the number two is. So that works for me. Right, push guard, move seal and fried eggs. See, I read that very quickly. Right, what do you want? And some braised tofu. We've got 13, so... It was Craven Meat there. You took two off me. That's a bit greedy. Alright, we got that out the way. And what else have we got? Let's see. Oops, I actually want to look at the list. Number 6. Well, number 3 says you should focus on looking for Bertram, so maybe I've got to keep doing the story to unlock those ones. But number 6 enjoys dominating others, so that means we have to be masochist then. Okay, so I don't see it on the list, the sort of map here, so I may have to go all the way up then. That's fine. Right, so we do have a bat here that I was going to kind of look into, so let's have a look.
Bring it on.
May as well get a list of all the enemies in this area. Right, we've got a vampire bat. Okay, so it's got 221 HP and 266 SP. Alright, that's fine. Let me just very quickly then start getting rid of these guys. I do want to kind of see if I can steal anything from this bat though, just to see where it drops. Dracus scale, okay. I don't recall actually needing one of them, so maybe for something else.
I'll take you on. Here I come.
There we go. So I can get through the enemies in this area very quickly, so that's not too bad. Right, so we've got some hollow bone, Dracus scale, move seal, worn out, drill and pop gun, shampooers. We've got 130 gold, 330 experience and 108 points. Kind of hoping one or two of my other affinity charm things will level up as we're here. Okay, so we've fought those, in fact we've fought those big green things. So a treasure, this is locked, okay. I want that treasure chest here though. Out mirror, sour milk and braised tofu. Okay, well that was probably cause for that other thing. It was a flying one. Have I been here? No, so that's just the other end. Okay. Just trying to keep an eye on the map so I don't get confused and lost. There's a flying one over there which we probably won't be able to get. Right, can I get past this thing without fighting? Yes, I can. Right, so there's a couple of ways here. There's a safe crystal, might as well use it while I'm here. Right, so where have we to go? Let me check the map. Right, we've got to go straight forward. Okay. Let's see, so we've got a couple of ways. Oh, and that's the one I'm looking for over here. I saw a pink thing on the screen. It is. Okay. Right, what was number 6? It enjoys dominating others, so I need to be masochist, which is number 7. Right, it's at 7%, so hopefully that's going to be enough. Can I run past? Right, so it enjoys dominating others. Let's see if this will work. So we want to do Sultry, Cry and Forgive Me. Usually Forgive Me is the one that boosts itself right up very quickly.
Everyone's looking at me.
Why aren't you punishing me?
Oh, very close. Okay, I know. I should be able to do it though with 7%, I think. Right, we'll try that again. Okay, so let's see. I'm not keen on what those ones were. Bashful, Salute, and Forgive Me again.
I just can't stay still.
Ooh, might get it this time. Orders. There we go.
This is definitely embarrassing.
So definitely I'd say 7%. 6 can do it, but 7% seems to work okay here. Right, do I have any more? Nope, okay, so definitely wants me to do story based then. Right. So there's a treasure chest there, we can't because it's floating. Looks like there's treasure chests on our side, so I guess I've got to do the cutscene because I kind of have to open up additional spots on the map. So is there any... Oh, there's a treasure chest here. Cheerleader, Skirt, Paralysis and Sour Milk. Okay, can I go down here? Uh, No. Okay. Jump! Is this something I'm gonna need for the area to get across? If that's the case, I think it's the same for the other side. Seems like there's another enemy over there we haven't fought. Okay, but I guess that's probably because we can't get there. Wanna see if this other side's the same. It is. Okay, so I've probably got to activate an area skill or something at some point down the line. I need you to move away, mate, because you're just going to end up hitting it right into me. I don't want to battle again. Right, so let's just go and head to the cutscene then. See if it opens up any more. I should probably heal as well, just in case it's another battle. Let's see what I'm at. We're all right. I could probably do a little heal here and there. Seems we have a few anyway. I just want to make sure you're all right. Sour milk. I'll give one to Serma. Everybody else could be okay. Right, I think that's the kind of best I can do. I don't want to kind of use up any enemies just in case there's no a battle, but. Own mallet. When you get to kind of points in an area, especially like this, it kind of indicates there's going to be a battle of some sorts. Right, something's going on.
Whoa, what's all this about? There's a huge crowd gathering together. Oh, yeah, you're right. I wonder what's going on. Maybe there's a celebrity.
Whatever it is, it looks like fun. Come on, let's go check it out.
Ow, ow, ow! Stop pulling my hair! I'm going!
Come on! Why do you guys always have to take stupid detours like this?
Don't blame me. Shushers is the one making me do it.
Quit your belly aching. Oh, I know. We can try and gather some information while we're there. Okay, then. It's decided. Now mush! Yeah!
My hair!
She says that, but she has absolutely no intention of gathering any information, does she?
Yep, this is how things generally go. Lady Shushu, wait for us!
So many people.
Can't breathe.
Good heavens, Rayo's going to get crushed.
Hey, are you okay? Here, get up on my shoulders.
So high. Thanks, Kame.
Nah, it's no problem at all.
Aw, lucky.
I thought she might say that.
Get together is this? There's just a bunch of guys here.
Hey everyone! Thanks for waiting!
Huh? That voice!
I'm guessing it's Alice.
Yeah, sounds super familiar.
Holy cow! What the heck was that?
That scared me!
Hey, you don't need to cry. They're there.
The devilish idol and demon lord Alice has arrived on Silverworld! All right!
All right! She's here! Alice is really here!
Lady Alice!
These people here just to see her?
She just called herself Alice. Isn't that the girl you guys were talking about earlier?
Yep, that's Alice, our pop idol traveling companion.
And it looks like she's as popular as ever.
Huh, why the hell is she so popular anyway? She's just a little punk weakling.
Now, there's no point in getting upset at things like that.
Yeah, Shisho! Don't get mad!
Whatever. Let's just get over there already. Come on.
But there's so many people in the way.
Lady Alice, take me now.
Creepy.
More yelling? Huh? That voice sounded really familiar.
Yeah, you're right. But the only person we know on this planet is Alice.
Gah! Gah! It's too much to handle! I'm in love!
Is Alice your master?
Huh? Oh.
Oh, thank goodness. I don't know what I would have done if I'd missed Lady Alice's performance. Did she just wink at me? Oh, don't make me fall even deeper in love, Lady Alice! L-O-V-E-A-L-Y-S! Alice, Alice, Alice!
Yeah, I'm not really sure what to say myself, to be honest with you.
Was that...
Silly girl, be quiet before he notices us.
If I'm not mistaken, that's the guy from before, right?
Yep, pretty sure that's him.
What should we do? I feel like we should probably avoid him for now. For more reasons than one.
Good idea. First things first, let's go see Alice. Forward march! You there, out of the way!
I've been saving this just for you guys. Get ready for the first performance of my brand new hit single!
Lady Alice!
My turn again, right. That was so much fun. Everybody was really into it, or everyone. I'm just a natural born idol, I guess. I've only just arrived on this world, and I'm already beloved by everyone here. Excuse me, good evening, Lady Alice. Bertram, were you in the audience today? Well, how was it? What do you think of my show? You are most lovely every day, but today you were simply phenomenal. Indeed, I mistook you for a goddess descended from the heavens. Oh, come on, really? You're just saying that? No, it's absolutely true. I'm unable to speak anything but the truth in your presence. Oh, you're so good at flattery. Not that it doesn't feel nice, of course. Oh, they all want an encore, it seems. Lady Alice, please sing one more. Now, you never always do one more, because then they'll just want another and another. We want to see you again. Oh, I guess they're not satisfied yet. I'll have to go back out there. Lady Alice, you shouldn't strain yourself if you're tired. Not at all. I feel good, so I think I'll give them a little extra. We'll see you later. Yes, ma'am. I shall support you from the audience once again. Now then, I have no time to waste. I must retrieve my cheering paraphernalia and... Well, my! I completely forgot to tell Lady Alice about the trouble I encountered, Lady Alice. Yes, I guess she is going to be your master then. Everyone, thanks for waiting. I've come back just for you. Well, there's nobody else. Yeah, what do you think you're doing? Finally got through. Huh? I recognise that voice. Ah, you there. You're not allowed up on stage. I'm sorry, but she made me. Hey, I asked you a question. What in the holy hell do you think you're doing? Ugh, so I did hear Lady Shushu's voice, but you're obviously not Shushu. I'm Serma. Shushu's is here too. See? Huh? What do you mean, I don't see her? Right here. Look closer. Huh? That little thing squirming around, is that really Shushu? Don't call me that little thing, and of course it's me. Oh, she's not... No, well, yeah, she finds it quite funny then. You don't laugh. Of course I'm gonna laugh. What is this? You're like a little pink marshmallow. That's hilarious. This is so funny. Alice is laughing at me because of you. Stupid, stupid, stupid. No more noogies. Hey, don't mock her so much. If she gets upset, we'll be the ones that suffer. Yeah, you really shouldn't laugh so much, Lady Shushu. Looks like, sorry. Shouldn't laugh so much. Lady Shushu looked just as adorable at that size as ever. Maybe we should be up here. Yeah, sorry, should we be up here? There's a big audience watching. What the hell? What's going on? Is this part of the performance? They look like they know Lady Alice. Those other girls are pretty cute too, especially that girl in the Hakama. Is that Hakama? Hey, don't lose your faith in Lady Alice so fast. Besides, the girl on that old guy's shoulders is way cuter. They're all cute, so who cares? I guess they've reached an understanding. Oh, you're all here too. And there's some new faces I see. Hmm. Well, what are you staring at? You must be charmed by how cute I am. I don't get it. What's so great about a girl like her? What do you mean a girl like me? You may not understand because you're a girl, but from a guy's perspective, I'm extremely cute. Did you hear that? To be honest, I don't know what everyone sees in the Missy either. I only have eyes for Lady Shushu. What? You're all just so weird. To normal people, I'm the cutest one around, and that's just how it is. I'm not saying you're not cute, but you're super weak too, right? I just don't get why you're this popular. Super? You guys? What kind of crap have you been telling her? But it's true, you're super weak. Quit repeating it. Lady Alice, you mustn't get near them. They're after you. Ooh, I guess I should introduce you, huh? They can be a pain, but these are the travelling companions I told you about. Seriously though, total pain. You don't have to emphasise it. What? Then these are... why are they after you? Ah, I think you may have got a bit confused. I guess we should probably fill him in. Do we have to? Okay, go ahead, Nosy. I'm not doing it, you are. Jeez, what's the hold up? They're just standing there talking. Hey, move around or something. Someone take your clothes off. That's not the kind of show I think these were kind of entitled to view here. Shut up, we're having a serious discussion here. Everyone, just wait a bit longer, please. So that's what's going on. Does that all make sense? Yes, understand perfectly well. Ultimate God, huh? You sure like getting yourself involved in trouble. I didn't get involved on purpose. So we were looking around for whoever was in charge again, assuming it would be the Ultimate God, but it's probably Bertram. We never imagined it'd be you. Oh, is it going to be Alice now? Yeah, with my natural charming personality, conquering a world like this is a piece of cake. Whatever, thanks to you we have to start our search from scratch. Well, why? When you're listening, we're looking for the Ultimate God. Yeah, I know. So you can stop looking, right? Ah, that's right. I didn't actually tell you, did I? It's probably you. I'm in fact the god of this world, although I'd forgotten the specific title of Ultimate God. Huh? What? That's right. Ah, even a god can't escape my charms. What a devilishly enchantress I am. Enough of that. So this is the ultimate god, huh? Well, we did beat him. I did get the sense he was pretty strong-minded man when we first met him. But after seeing his sudden change later on... Okay, so if Betty goes inside this coffin for us, we'll be all done here. Shush, why do I always have to take care of things for you? Shoo-shoo. Sorry, but could you help her out? I can't refuse Lady Alice's request, however, I must ask something first. See, it's never that easy, is it? Huh? What is it? After this is done, what do you plan to do with Lady Alice? Well, what are you going to do, Shushers? Take her with me, of course. She is my peon, after all. Aww, but it was so nice getting pampered here. Oh well. Well, you know what they say, it was just a business trip. In that case, I can't agree to your request. Huh? Excuse me? Why not? Lady Alice is the ray of hope bringing joyful light to this world. And besides, I can't allow you to take her against her will, not as her servant. And it's not, I'm not as god of this world. Things are getting out of hand again. As long as we don't have to battle, I'm fine with it. You don't want to come with us? Well, I don't really like the peon treatment, but I can't say the adventuring isn't fun. As you can see, she clearly doesn't wish to leave. She didn't say that. Are you going to have to do this the hard way again? Hope this doesn't end in violence, but we did win the last time though. I am well aware how powerful your group is, however, my only object is to protect Lady Alice, which means, if Elka finds out, you're going to be in trouble. Which means you're probably going to want to battle me again, aren't you? Lady Alice, please forgive me. Huh? Wait, don't pick me up like that. I'll flee with Lady Alice until you give up. Even if it takes 10 years, oh god, you're gonna disappear. Yep, oh yeah, you're gonna disappear, right. And he's running away again, so we're gonna have to chase him all down again. Rio, go, don't let him get away this time. Oh, she's off to sleep, she's tired out and tuckered. Why are you asleep? I guess you got bored from all the talking. To be honest, it's been a long conversation, this one. Hey, this isn't nap time, make your stupid feet. Fast feet useful for once. Huh? Scared me. Ah, come on, don't cry. Give me a break. She just fell asleep. Sorry, I didn't mean to shout. Come on, be a good girl and don't cry. Oh, too late. Well, I guess we lost them again. Guess we're gonna have to go chase them down again then, aren't we? Don't just stand there looking around. Come on, after them. Oh yeah, hey, get back here. So what the heck was that? Oh yeah, you forgot you're all still kind of standing there waiting for a song. I was expecting some flashy fight or scene or something. Are we even sure that was the performance? Well, we'll leave it to your imagination, shall we? Then Lord Bertram really kidnapped Lady Alice and what? Oh no, Lady Alice has been kidnapped. There you go, thanks for catching on. Lord Bertram's gone mad, he's all gonna go chase him down. Oh, okay. Right, that seems like... Is there another... Oh, there is one in the centre there. Okay, so we're not done with cutscenes then. Right. We still can't do any, so I guess we've just got to kind of go straight to the cutscene again. Oops, I just wanted to double check the map. For the other side, but yeah, if we can't really do anything, I guess we've just got to go straight to the cutscene. Hopefully it's not going to be as lengthy as the one we just did. May as well just do a save there, because that was quite a lengthy cutscene. Right, where was it? So I've got to go down and round and down, okay, that's fine. I've got We'll try and avoid all these again.
Jump.
Right, we totally lost them. Man, he's so fast. Barry, where are you? Come out if you can hear me. I really doubt this is gonna work. Ryu, do you think you could find them by scent? Ryu? Don't treat her like a dog. I mean, sorry, the idea just came to me. Well, what are we gonna do? Just walk around blindly? Just walking around sometimes, just walking around sometimes boring. Oh, I know. As long as we're here, let's purify this planet. Again? Yeah, we're going to be moving all over the stars later anyway, so why not get it over with? That's true. I don't want to walk back later again. That sounds nice and all, but do we really have time for detours? It's not a bad idea. I doubt he's even been running around this entire time. He's probably holed up somewhere. Ah, the ruins. I couldn't find it earlier, where the weapon was resting. Wow, Lady Shushu, we found this thanks to you. You're so brilliant. She shows amazing. I keep thinking of Snow White when I'm looking at that. Ah, naturally. That's just speculation, though. Oh well, it's pointless trying to talk sense into you. I mean, geez, you are stupid. Why are you suddenly calling me stupid? Because with what's her name, Alice, all you had to say was, would you leave her here and we'd probably happily have gotten in the coffin. Then we wouldn't have been in this mess. I could never do that, absolutely not. I'm not saying you actually had to do it, you just had to say you were going to do it, you know, a lie. Even if it's a lie, I still can't say it. You care more about your friends than I thought. It's not like that, she's a peon, not a friend. My peons belong to me, so I can't give them to anyone. Ah, Shushers is blushing. Red face, red face. Shut up over there. Quit this nonsense and turn this planet into a peon already. Okay, okay. Are we now gonna start doing stuff? It seems like it. I'm not really in a good spot though. Can I go over here just to kind of get out of the way? So I'm a bit not in front of everybody. Right, okay, so we do have a number 3. Let's see. I think we're fine with that, with the 70 times 5 plus 5, yeah, we're fine. So where is number 3? I think I see it there. Yeah, it's just next to it, so that's fine. It's on the other side of this little gap. Oh, we're over 1,000 now. Okay, I did a bit more battling than I thought I did already. There we go. Now we've already did the first few, so I thought maybe that was that gonna peonify the area there. Right. Phew. We should be safe in here. Lady Alice, I apologize for the inconvenience, but please stay there, please stay here. Just for a short time. Huh? Where are we? It's so dark. Oh, did I just get kidnapped? I may be an idol, but I can't handle that sort of thing. Ah, I thought you were a good person. Please calm down. I truly apologise for my discourtesy. Once matters have been settled, please cast me away or do whatever you wish with me. You're not going to do anything weird to me. What do you mean, weird? You know, like, perverted stuff? Perverted? Absolutely not. I do indeed love and respect my Lady Alice, but my feelings have never fallen to lust. No, not once. Okay then, I guess that's a relief. But I'm sure Shushu is fuming mad right now. Do you wish to return to them, Lady Alice? Just say yes. Well, it's not like I really want to go back, but see, if I'm not with them, it's like the group's mood gets really dark, you know? Or like they can't start the show without me. I see. Lady Alice's existence is much like the sun, no matter where she goes. Huh? You just accepted that easily, huh? Oh, but you know about, but what about you, Bertram? Why do you want me to stay so badly? You were the head honcho here before I arrived, right? So me leaving wouldn't be that big of a deal, would it? As I said before, I love and respect you, Lady Alice. And this feeling isn't just mine, but that of everyone who lives on this world. Again, I do apologise if I'm butchering all. There's been quite a lot of talk in this episode, and sometimes when it keeps going too long, I eventually start kind of just seeing the words jumble on the screen a bit, and it gets difficult to kind of keep doing it. Yeah, you flatter me too much. It's almost kind of embarrassing. I've governed over this world as a god for many years. I've only been driven by the sense of purpose without any memory of my past. I've put in my utmost effort, however, I am but a lone, insignificant man. Not once was I able to bring a smile to the faces of the residents of this world. This is no surprise, of course. I've never laughed from the bottom of my heart myself. Really? I did think this world was a bit bland when I first got here. When I first met you, Lady Alice, it came as a complete shock to me. My chest pounded, my heart danced, a smile came to my face naturally. At that moment, you captivated me and everyone else here. You're flattering me again. But I think I understand. It could be that deep down the people here were a lot like the people of Fireworld. So it's only natural I'd become popular here. Yep. Unfortunately, I've resorted to bringing you along by force. However, if it is your wish, I will overcome my heart-trending grief and... Whoa, your eyes are super scary right now. If that's how things are here, I might, you know, consider staying. How very kind. I, Bertram, reaffirm my vow to serve you for the remainder of my life. It's a bit much, to be honest with you, but okay. I think maybe you're overreacting a bit. But if Shushu hears about this, she's sure to get even more angry. What to do? Alright, at least that cutscene wasn't as long as the last one, right? Do we have any more in this area? I don't see any, so maybe we have to kind of just keep peeing and everything. Right, so number 4, it's any complicated girls. That's probably going to be bipolar. Right, so where was it again? Right, so it's just before the crystal. Okay. Just try to make sure I don't get lost when I'm doing things here. Jump. Okay, that's fine. Right, let's give this a go. So it's complicated. So, love beam, got a problem, and bad.
You'd better catch hold of my heart, okay?
Nope, definitely not. Alright, so bad boosted it up. Bad. So again, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of do a transition cut to when I do get it, right? So I'm not kind of doing a tons of battling in between everything.
It's not like I'm sexy or anything. It's not like I'm angry at you.
Alright, I finally got it. I didn't think that one was going to make it there. For some reason, it just kind of decided to do it there, but okay. We finally got that one. Oh, okay, so we did actually pee on it at the same time, so... Atlet's lovable this time around. Usually I'm used to the claw hand thing, but okay. And we've got 2,149 gold, no experience, 1,383 points. We've got some fighty, is that flighty shampoo, some nimble shampoo, apple candy, pop gun, newbie nurse, and dust bunny shampoo roos. Serus is now 7%. Bipolar. Okay.
Okay, that's the last of them. Now we should be able to find his hideout.
Ooh.
You really think it'll be that easy?
If I say we'll find him, we'll find him. Come on, chop chop.
Why are you always so pushy, Shooshers?
Oops, I didn't mean to press it that quickly there. I don't think it skipped anything.
See? It worked! Just like I said.
Wow. Impressive, Shooshers.
Well, there's no guarantee he's actually in there, though.
Considering how subplots like this usually go, I'm pretty sure he's in there. Come on, he's gonna get away if you don't hurry.
What was that? An earthquake?
This can't be. Did they find us?
Which means it's only a matter of time before Shushu shows her face.
Oh, I bet she's really mad.
Okay, well, we're not gonna leave because I kinda wanna get the rest of these if it's possible. Wait, let me just do a quick, go back to Ego just now, and I'll do a quick save. Right, so what am I looking for here? Number 5, it wants some stylish vision correction accessories, okay. 5's here. Thin framed glasses, I don't have any. I don't know if I can buy any from the, because they kind of look like the clothes item stuff, and maybe I need to buy some. Actually, if that's the case, would I be better trying to go back to the thingy just now, see if I can buy any? What was it? Let me just double check what that item was. Thin frame glasses. Let me just double check. We can leave. Hopefully it's not going to do anything if we leave. Nope, okay, that's fine. Right, I'm going to check, see if I can actually buy thin framed lenses or glasses or something, is it? Thin framed glasses. It's 1,000. I'm going to buy a pair. Oops, just one, thanks. Oh, I've got an eye mask I didn't know I had, okay. Just so I can go back here and get that planet point. Okay, so it's opened up Galee's Ruins, okay, but I'm gonna go back to Silver World just now because I want to kind of finish this area off if possible, just because I kind of want to try and get, don't you dare attack, thank you. I just want to try and get as much done as possible because it kind of helps us build up our charm levels. Right, so that bit there is still not going to let us in, which is okay. I don't need to worry about that. There you go, we managed to actually get through that pretty quickly there without any interruptions. So now I should be able to get this, as long as I only wanted one, because I didn't realise that. That's okay, only wanted one. If I wanted another pair, I'd have had to have went back and got another one. That's alright. Okay, so number 8, it wants a weapon like Umbrella and also a beam. I have no idea what that is. Where is that anyway? Number 8's there. So I need to go to the left hand side. Well, yeah, the left hand side. We'll have a look and see if we have a weapon for this. A parasol beam, which I do not have apparently, so I guess I have to go back to the weapon store, see if I can maybe buy it. I'm not going to do it now because I don't want to kind of waste any more time. Let's see, where was number 9? 9's over the other side, okay. We'll just do as many as we can here just now. It all kind of helps, I guess. Now, one guessing the other this side will possibly be like the other side. You're not going to let me go past a certain point. Ideally, I'd rather that thing wasn't there, though. Oh, you are going to let me through. Okay, I didn't realise you would... I thought you would have been like the other side. Is there any enemies here? Oh, there is an enemy. Okay, I didn't nearly see that there. I want that treasure chest in case it has something that I need.
Hey, I found
Wild coat, sugar candy and stuff, okay. I guess you're not going to let me go that side, are you? Yes, okay, that was fine. There is a few treasure chests in the other areas that I kind of feel like I need to go and get as well. I kind of missed a few. What did this want? Number 9 was energetic girls. Okay, so that's going to be hyper. That's already 7%, so we shouldn't have too much hassle with that. So let's do... Oh god. Right. Meow meow. Bratty and Hop. Usually Bratty and Hop tend to be okay.
No, 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 no!
There we go. That works for me. Go the other way because I can't get any of those flying things. Right, so we can't do number 8. So number 10 is 340 enemies, which we have over 1,000, so we're fine with that. So let's just grab this one while we're here. I don't think there was any enemies in this section. Is there any treasure chest? Didn't actually notice the last time when we were in this section, but nope, okay. Right, so only 1 to 340, which we've got plenty. Right, so we only have one, which was a parasol beam. So we're going to do a very quick check at the item store and see if we have any available. Let's just leave. Right, so we'll just have a quick look to see if we have a parasol beam, I think it was. Parasol beam, parasol beam. I'm not... Oh, he's got something there for a butcher's sword. Okay. Right, I don't see a parasol beam, which means I don't think I can get... Oh, wait, no, that was a metal beam, wasn't it? Okay. So it's not the same thing. Alright. Yeah, so we don't have access to a parasol beam. So maybe what we need to do is kind of leave it here for today. What we're going to do in the next episode is we're going to go back and revisit a couple of these worlds just to try and gain the additional sort of spots. I don't think we can do the Rose World one. I think that kind of wants me, it says we to visit another world. We'll go back in and try it again just now we've done Silver World. See if we can try and maybe get that last one. Then what we're going to do is go back into Spicer Ruins and try and see if we can get all the sort of planet points for this area, and then once we've done that we'll jump into the Galee's Ruins, if that's what it's called. So that's kind of feels like that's going to be the plan. In the meantime, as I say, what I'll probably do is maybe do a little bit of level grinding. Maybe if I do a little bit of level grinding, that parasol beam will become available in the store, and if not, then as I say, we'll just kind of go from there. But other than that, guys, thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you all again next time.